I'm back. So I literally just had a conversation about ball and chain. I showed you guys some of my favorite websites on Snapchat. So if you guys want to see what I'm up to, feel free to follow me at I am Karen O. All right, back to the regular programming. So today I'm going to show you guys some of the things that I've aggregated over the months and also from AliExpress. Maybe before I jump to AliExpress items, I'll give you a little bit of background of my experience with AliExpress because it is my first time using it. To be frank, I've actually had no problems. I've been hearing a lot of comments about some people not receiving their items or it's a scam, but personally, I didn't run into any of that. And I actually did share some of my favorite stores or some of the stores that I bought these clothing items from. But don't worry, all of that will be linked in the description box below. Feel free to check it out. Without further ado, let's just hop in. Okay, I'm back. You guys may or may not know, but if you don't know by now, I think I really like stripes. I guess I liked it so much I accidentally ordered 2 striped tops. So the reason why I ordered these is because I wanted to wear these under graphic tees. Wherever you're living at right now, if it's a little cooler, that is one way you can pair an outfit. And I actually did that in my last lookbook video on how I style graphic tees, so you can feel free to check it out. I will have like a bubble right here, or the little info bar will come out and you can click either this side or that side. And these are just so versatile. They're actually pretty good quality and it's very, very warm. So I was definitely sweating in this in Los Angeles, but when I went back to the Bay Area last weekend, this top kept me nice and comfy and cozy. My verdict is I like to buy basics on AliExpress. I don't buy like the $2-3 basics. I tend to go for like the $15 basics, which is like the more expensive stuff. Ooh, so expensive, right? But yeah, the quality is actually really decent. This top right here, it's just a t-shirt. I also got it for $15, but don't quote me on that. Just check the link in the description box and you'll see how much I paid for it. This is actually a really thick, like good quality t-shirt. I don't know if you can tell from here, but it's not thin. You can't see through it. It does keep me very, very warm. Another basic top that I picked up is literally a high neck black sweatshirt. And I wanted something black because I actually don't own anything like that. I love prints and I love color. I don't know how long this will actually stay simply black because I did pick up a whole bunch of patches, and which I might make a video just around patches and pins. And I might just start patching those patches all over this black sweater so I can customize it and make it my own. When I get high. I am really into androgynous cuts right now, like outfits that will work for both guys and girls. I don't know if you guys remember back in the 90s or even early 2000s, or maybe they're still around, but they were like little tiny Dixie cups that you, at the dentist office, they would have this print all over it. I picked this up because I think this will look really cute with boyfriend jeans and a pair of slip-ons, like a white slip-ons, something really casual and comfortable. You may or may not know this, but I am really obsessed with primary colors right now. It's really hard for me to pick a favorite color because it really changes a lot with my mood. So right now I'm feeling the colors of the rainbow and I'm gravitating towards primary colors. I bought this one because I wanted to have more crew necks. I realized I don't have a lot of crew necks and I kind of went a little nuts on AliExpress because the price was fairly cheap.
Hey, bring the, no, we good. Yeah.
All right. I decided to pick up 2 pairs of jeans, and I've seen this cut on a lot of Korean fashion websites, really inspired by their androgynous style lately. They're all white. What you'll notice with a lot of these pants is that the hem is frayed and it's kind of disheveled looking, which I'm really into. And there's a little like knee slit right here. The cut is a little bit more bell-shaped. I'm gonna be real, they're not exactly the most flattering pants, but I think that's kind of the point of the whole androgynous look, is that it's not really flattering your body, but it's more comfortable and more boyish. I like them because I'm actually really short, so they actually sit right above my ankles. I know technically and generally they don't look good on everyone, But if you pair it with a pair of like white slip-ons, something that really slims your feet down, it actually looks really cute. But ask me if I love myself, I'm like, I actually picked up two of those jeans. The same type of style, I just wanted like a deeper wash. I think they're really versatile too. Same type of cut, a little bit more frayed at the end of the pants. If you guys want to see how I style these type of jeans, they're like the new invented version of the mom jeans in my opinion. Then let me know in the comment section down below and I will make a video around it. I'm fresh as hell. I decided to try some shoes too. And I picked up these really simple and basic black, kind of like skater shoes. I'm not gonna lie though, they smell like factory. And for the price that you're paying, I feel like that is what you're gonna probably get back. These are really cute and they would go with all the jeans that I showed you guys. And I feel like these are just essentials that you can have in your closet. I actually picked up another pair, but without laces, and they are white and I've been wearing them to death already. If you follow me on Instagram, I feel like I keep saying that, but if you do, then you've actually seen them already. They're already kind of dirty, which I don't mind. I like the whole lived in look. Everything good, everything good, everything good, everything good, everything. So the final pair of shoes that I picked up from AliExpress are these Mary Jane chunky clunky shoes. I was actually inspired by these, this type of style on unif.com. However, I think they were like $100+ and I wasn't really feeling like paying $100+. So I decided to go on AliExpress, searched for Mary Janes. And this is actually what came up. When I bought these, I was thinking about wearing like androgynous fit with Mary Janes. And I think it turned out really cute.
Hey, Brenda, not we good. Yeah.
All right. It's just a t-shirt, but it's not just a t-shirt. The last haul you saw, I was really into 60s items. I think I grew up out of that phase really fast. I'm pretty sure, and I know a lot of 60s influence still stuck around with me, like the primary colors and just using a lot of colors in general. That kind of translated, if you fast forward 20 years, the 80s, you'll notice that this is kind of the background is where I got my inspiration from. It screams 80s or early 90s to me. I love the color. Even though it makes me look like a carrot, I am okay with that. Carrot Karen. For the rest of the items, aka accessories, I'm gonna be doing a quick lookbook for you guys, so enjoy. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. If you guys liked the video, feel free to give it a thumbs up. If you want to, you don't have to. I also have Instagram, I'm on Snapchat, I'm also on YouNow, I'm on Twitter. Feel free to drop by and say hi because I love responding to your guys' comments. And if you guys recreate any of the looks that I create, feel free to tag me or hashtag BBHood so I can find it and like your pictures. I will see you guys next time. I love you guys so much. and bye. What's up, guys? Obviously, it's me, Karen. I don't know why I keep saying that, but it's me. Rolling.
Touching without hands, because you're dead.